I do use quite a few beaver floats, and here's a prime location why I use them. There's no place to make any kind of conibear set, foothold set here, so I incorporate a beaver float. And this is not my idea. This was a trapping partner's idea here a couple years ago, and we made a whole bunch of floats together, and I kind of incorporated his idea, and works very, very well. So yeah, that's a very, very good tool for all these cattail choked spots. We will get him out of here, and then I'll show you how to set it up on here. Easy to do, just I put my foot right there just to hold it up. Set the trap. Dog pointing in, just like you're doing to do like a castor mount setup on the bank. A lot of muskrat in this ditch. You can see a lot of muskrat droppings here. Move that over, get that out. Just like so. Both triggers are off, safeties are off. It's got that foam insulation, just like if you use it for a muskrat float for traps, exactly. But there is a catch to some of these, and I'll show you. Again, the state of Minnesota, we gotta have the trap half underwater, even if you use a float. So what I do is I take a rock, put it on the back like that to help push the back up, and I start putting debris up front. That puts a little bit of weight on it. Plus it helps kind of camouflage it from the human eye. All this stuff. Just like that. Now we're good. Still gonna get a little bit of grass for the sides over here. Sometimes they like to come in from the side, so I'm just blocking it off. And then all I do is take my lure, try to get some of this debris out of here, but there we are. Take my lure and put it right back in the back here. That's all I do. Let's go check the next side.